Welcome all to yet another video Dr. RS and you on the science of cosmetics and personal care products. My name Ramesh Surya Narayanan, S-U-R-I-A. You can type in the YouTube videos, you can get all my videos regarding this topic, and this is my email ID. Right? Now, we are going to part 114 of the YouTube video. This is the 114th YouTube video on this topic, on the herbal cosmetics. We are going to discuss about cosmos. Right? We discussed about the organic concepts, no? Cosmetics, organic concepts. So we said that in part 113 we discussed about organic cosmetics. We discussed that organic cosmetics, basically what they do is they follow organic agricultural regulations and try to comply to organic agricultural regulation to make cosmetic products. We discussed how that is possible in part 113 and what are the limitations. So there are no regulations for organic cosmetics till recently. Cosmos is a private body. See, Cosmos is a private body which gives certification for organic and natural cosmetics, right? And we will see what is organic and what is natural, right? Based on the organic herb content. Organic herb content in the formulation, they classify as organic and natural, right? So, Cosmos has laid down rules and regulations for organic and natural cosmetics. We will briefly see about those. I would like to point out, Cosmos is a private body. It's not an official regulatory body by the government. It's a private body that has laid down regulations for organic and herbal cosmetics. Right? So, in the concept of the organic cosmetics, we also said that lot of people started approving for organic cosmetics. They had the regulations for organic cosmetics. It was under lot of confusion. So, what happened? Five leading private bodies having independently herbal and organic body regulation from Europe, right, they are from Europe, came together to have a broader perspective in setting up regulation for herbal and organic cosmetics. The five private bodies are BDIH of Germany, Cosme Bio of France, EcoCert of France, ICEA Italy, and Soil Association Great Britain. Okay. They joined, all these five bodies joined, and from these efforts, Cosmos standards were laid down. Okay, what is that? COS, I told you before itself, cosmetic, organic and natural standards, right? Cosmos, cosmetics, COS, COSM, cosmetic, organic and natural standards, okay, has set regulations for natural and organic cosmetic products. The standards are globally recognized by cosmetic industry, right? It's a private regulation, right? So there are two types of approval, cosmetics natural and cosmetics, Cosmos natural and Cosmos organic. These are the logos you can have on the label if you are approved by these people. They are all private bodies. Again, I'm repeating, it's a private body. Right. Now, before going further, I will introduce a concept called green chemistry. Okay. Ingredients approved by Cosmos based on the green chemistry. What is green chemistry? Green chemistry is an approach of chemical synthesis and extraction procedures considering environment. Anastas and Warner has originally published 12 principles of green chemistry, which is considered as a roadmap for chemists to implement the green chemistry. One of the key principles to green chemistry is elimination of solvents in chemical process or replacement of hazardous solvents with environmentally cleaner solvents. So this is the reference. You can read all the publications of Anastas P.T. Warner J.C. 1988 Green Chemistry, Theory and Practice, Oxford University Press, New York. Right. There are a lot of publications from Anastas and books. So you can read on green chemistry. Basically, all the cosmetic ingredients of, first of all, organic is one aspect of it, organic ingredients. And the second aspect is all the cosmetic ingredients that use green chemistry in synthesizing the ingredients, those were also used, and the exhaustive list is given in the Cosmos regulation based on these aspects, right? So again, the renewable source and the green chemistry, right? So this is the green chemistry. So Cosmos, what they in Cosmos standards, detailed guidelines are given on the following aspects. Introduction covering objectives and documents required, the regulations, the scope of the regulations, various definitions, general aspects, precautionary principles, sustainability, origin and processing of ingredients, covering ingredient categories and rules for organic percentage calculation. So what happens? If you use certain percentage of organic, above a certain percentage of organic in your product, then you can claim that your product is organic. However, even in natural calculation, natural, you should have certain percentage of organic in that also. So there is a guideline which shows the rules and regulations of how to calculate the organic percentage and all those aspects. Then regulations on storage, manufacturing and packaging, including regulations of fabrics that can be used for products like facial wipes, face masks, etc. That has to be environmentally friendly. Environmental management plan, right? This is very, very important. And details on labeling and communication, and finally the certification. So Cosmos, if you get the certification, there are frequent inspection, annual inspection from the authorities, right? That even though you have the approval initially with all the audits, every year audit is there to confirm that all the standards are adhere to. Now what we will do is, we will go to their website, right, and see very briefly what are the aspects given, right? This is Cosmos standard documents, okay, the complete Cosmos document including definitions, right? So the complete Cosmos standard, no, it's June 2020, So what are the table of contents? So you can get it in the so main objectives, right? Here, integrating and developing the concept of green chemistry, right? That's what I explained you. What is green chemistry? So the documents, Cosmos standard, no? What are the, you can go through this, the scope, then definitions, what are the definitions? Then what are the origin of and the processing of ingredients, what is allowed, right? Now, so see how the organic percentage is calculated, that is also given. Then these are all the rules and regulations, right? So how the environmental management, right? So compliance with ISO 14000 or national legislation that already covers this will be accepted. So you should have a environmental management plan to your factory setup. So what is natural certification, then certification and approval of ingredients. So detailed rules and regulations are given here. Then technical guide, so the list of certifying bodies, all the manuals, no? What are the definitions? All those things are there in this also, right? Then labeling, how to apply for cosmetic standard labels, right? The labeling guide, right? What are the labeling instruction? How you can label certified? It has to be labeled as organic cosmetic products. So examples of what is allowed: certified Cosmos organic shampoo, Cosmos organic certified, organic certified shampoo, certified organic shampoo. Not allowed organic shampoo, it's not allowed. You can't say it's an organic shampoo. That organic shampoo, you can, it's allowed only if you have 95% and above the above organic content, which I explained in the previous one. Shampoos, because of the surfactants and all those things, 95% is not possible. So you can't say organic shampoo. It's, you can say Cosmos approved organic shampoo, right? So various and what should be the label size and all those aspects are given in this exhaustively, right? How to apply, fees, certifying bodies. Who are the certifying bodies in your area for Cosmos, right? You have to register with the Cosmos, right? So when you register with Cosmos, you can get Cosmos certified organic ingredients, Cosmos approved natural raw materials, perfumers offering fragrance compositions which are Cosmos, and validated packaging. So you have to get the exhaustive list of all these things. What I have to do is you have to register with Cosmos, and then you can get the approved list of all the ingredients. Lot of raw material suppliers also advertise, no? 5 active ingredients from BASF for cosmetics and body care products have been approved as organic according to Cosmos standard, and they give the ingredient list. So Cosmos has laid down the complete rules and regulations for organic and natural cosmetics, which is quite exhaustive. There are a lot of products, cosmetic products in the market with Cosmos organic and natural approval. And once you start formulating products with the ingredient, approved ingredients by Cosmos, both organic and the natural ingredients, you can get a different perspective in formulation of the cosmetic products. Right? So in an approach to have a green, environmentally friendly cosmetic products, you can use the guide of Cosmos, and at this stage, with those rules and regulations, you can effectively formulate products that are green. Right? So this is what I want to share with you on Cosmos, which will be very helpful for any aspirant who want to make a green herbal cosmetics. Right? Cosmos is a very important regulation which you all should know if you are going for a green cosmetics, green herbal cosmetics. Right? Thank you for listening to me in this video. Till we connect in the next video, be safe, be happy, be smiling. Bye.